Okay, in this one, we're going to be looking at choosing an IT system. So, some of the things that we need to look at when choosing an IT system and why those things are important. So, the first one here is the user experience and needs. So, you guys can go ahead and read off here, but I'm going to give you my examples. For example, my user experience and my needs. I need a relatively cheap laptop that I can edit videos on. That I can take anywhere with me so it can't be too heavy. My user experience is also important. I've always used a Windows PC, so I'm very accustomed to how Windows is set up, how it works. I need to move quickly when I'm doing things. I don't want to be learning anything new. So, for example, for me buying a Mac OS or an iMac, anything Apple laptop would not be a good idea for me. Because there are specific things I need, which are all present in Windows. Some of them or most of them will be present in macOS as well. But for me, having to, the time it's going to take for me to learn that new system isn't going to be worth it. So, is the user experience with the computer system, or do they need a system that is easy to use? For me, that's a yes. I need to be accustomed to the system already. I don't want to learn anything new because that's just going to waste my time. All right, let's move on. So the next one, specifications, compatibility, and connectivity. Specifications, this is, does the system meet the specified requirements? So does it have a quad core processor? Does it have 4 gigabytes of RAM? Does it have at least a 500 gigabyte hard drive? Is it a laptop or is it a desktop? A laptop I need because I need to be portable. I use it to teach, I use it to edit videos, I use it to edit audio. So I'm going to need it to be portable. Compatibility. I'm going to need a system that's compatible with everything I already have. So, for example, again, yeah, let's use a Mac OS, the new Mac laptops, the iMac laptops, right? Or the MacBook Pro, I think it's called. The MacBook Pro is not compatible with everything I have immediately. Meaning, my current laptop now, I have 4 USB ports on here. I can plug in a mouse, a keyboard, a USB headset, and my phone all at the same time. And even a webcam as well, if I swap out one of them, right? But on the new macOS laptops, on the new MacBook Pros, I will, before I'm able to do that, I have to buy a dongle that costs me 60, £70 just to be able to use stuff I already have. Now, for me, in that regard, compatibility is not going to be great because before I can use the stuff I already have, I have to buy a MacBook Pro that costs me £2,000, and I have to go and buy an extra dongle that costs me 60, £70 just to use the stuff I already have. So for me, not going to be so great. Now, when we look at connectivity, I'm going to need Bluetooth on my laptop so I can use my Bluetooth headset, so I can send files from my phone. I'm going to also need, obviously, as I said before, a USB port or many USB ports. I'm going to need HDMI out, HDMI cable. Should work on my TV because sometimes I play videos from my laptop to my TV. I'm going to need a headphone jack so I can listen to music, so when I'm editing videos, I can hear everything clearly. I'm going to also potentially need, well, definitely Wi-Fi is going to be a must. I must have Wi-Fi. My current laptop doesn't have an Ethernet port, but it does have Wi-Fi. Now, most network providers now, so let's say Virgin or EE or Sky, they'll give you a free Wi-Fi modem or router or router when you get a service with them. So having Wi-Fi is a must for me. Now, cost is a big thing. When I was buying my laptop, I looked at how much my laptop was, which was £1,000 at the time, and I looked at how much the equivalent MacBook Pro was going to cost me. So the MacBook Pro, so the laptop, the thin laptop, has all the same specs. It had the Core i7 eighth gen processor. It had 16 gigabytes of RAM. It had 500 gigabytes of SSD storage. Everything was the same, except one was made by Apple, and the one I have now is made by Dell. The one made by Dell costs me £1,000. The same thing from Apple was going to cost me 2,700. Now, for me, it was a no-brainer, not just because of the price, but because of other factors as well. But someone similar to myself, looking at an two laptops, and they have a budget of £1,000 or £2,000 even, then they're going to have to go for the other one. Efficiency and productivity. is the efficiency of the system a key issue? I need my computer to be efficient in that I need the battery to last me, I don't know, 3-4 hours when not being charged. It needs to be productive. So does it have everything I need for me to be productive? I don't really type well on my laptop keyboard, so I can plug in a physical keyboard and type on there. I don't really like using the speakers that come with the laptop, the built-in one, so I plug in a headset. That's fine. That's kind of compatibility as well. So here it says, it is essential that the system is able to start up fast, load and save programs and files quickly. So again, productivity and efficiency. My computer is relatively fast. I can open any file if I have the right program, and it opens within seconds. I don't have to wait a whole minute or a minute and a half for things to open. And here we go. Does the user have the budget for the high-end machine? So this is kind of linked to cost, because the more expensive your machine normally, the more efficient and productive it's going to be. Now, I just countered my own argument saying that the MacBook Apple laptop was $2,700 and the same thing made by Dell was £1,000. So in some cases that's true, but in some cases it's not. Implementation. So what is the time scale for the IT system to be implemented? For me, it was a simple, let's say 1 hour, where I had to transfer all my files from an external hard drive back onto my new laptop. Now, if you're a company and you have to change out every single PC in the building, it's not going to take you an hour. It's going to take days, potentially weeks to do that. So implementation, so the downtime, the time it takes you to actually do this is important as well. Does the system need to be available quickly? In most cases, yes. Imagine if your high street bank closed down for 2 whole months just because they needed to swap the computers out, and the IT technicians doing it says, okay, well, there's no big rush, so we're going to just close the branch for 2 whole months while we do this work. Probably not going to be acceptable, right? Will the system need extensive testing? In most critical cases, yes. In my case, not really, because whilst I'm using the system, that's kind of me testing it as well. But again, if you're a bank and you just got brand new computers, you need to know if the internet connection is good enough for you to work from. You need to know if it's fast enough. You need to know quite a few things. So testing is essential for some systems. So when thinking about implementation, these are some of the questions that you do have to ask yourself. Next one. Will you need to migrate data from old system to the new one? I had to do that because I had all my files and my programs on my old laptop. I copied them onto my hard drive, my external hard drive, and copied them onto this newer laptop. Right, there are other ways of doing it. Some people clone the entire hard drive, meaning they just make a copy of every single thing on the hard drive. But I didn't want to do that, so I did it the slightly longer way, but worked out better for me. Will users need training in order to use a new system? In a bank, for example, let's stick to that example. If you're just changing out the PCs and you're using exactly the same software, exactly the same everything, you don't need new training, right? However, if you're a company, let's say, moving away from using Windows to using Macs, you're probably going to want to give people some training, because things work very differently on Macs. Yes, it's the same double click to open things. Yes, it's the same red X to close things. But when you dig a bit deeper, things tend to be more different. Okay, so the last one is security, probably one of the most important features here. Will the system handle sensitive information well? Now, again, let's stick to the bank example. The new computers, do they have security software installed or security features installed so that not everyone can just gain access? For example, you would need to have some form of antivirus installed on a banking computer. You might also need to have a fingerprint attached to the computer, so only that one person who's assigned to that computer will be able to use it. Does it need biometric security for login? Okay, we just kind of mentioned that. Are portable devices not appropriate because of the risk of them being stolen? Now, for a bank, yes, you don't want to be walking around a bank with a laptop that someone can quickly grab and run out of the bank. But for me, I don't really have any sensitive data on my laptop. Don't store my bank details anywhere on my laptop. And even so, to get into my laptop, you have to have a fingerprint of mine, where you have to use the key. So the username and password, let's say. Okay, so these are some of the features or some of the things that you need to think about when choosing any IT system, any digital system, right? So again, user experience and needs, specification, compatibility and connectivity, the cost, efficiency and productivity, implementation, and finally, security.